Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Manpreet Arora from Central University of Himachal Pradesh, Dharamshala. Today we are going to discuss about a module, Objectives and Functions of IMF, under the paper International Business Operations. After completing this module, you'll be able to understand the history and purpose or the objectives of IMF. Working and the functions of IMF, knowing the IMF's current role. The Great Depression of 1930s resulted in the downfall of various economies. Less availability of foreign exchange with the economies was a major issue to be tackled to sustain the economic systems. Therefore, most of the economies increased trade barriers and devalued their currencies in order to compete with the export market. The repercussions of such measures were increasing unemployment, deteriorating standard of living of people, decline in the world trade, and slowing down of economies as a whole. Therefore, in 1944, under an agreement, International Monetary Fund was created to reach upon a framework which could promote economic cooperation, thereby leading to a prosperous global economy. In this module, you'll be able to understand that why and how the IMF was created and what are the basic functions which IMF performs to promote or to foster and establish economic cooperations in the world economies. International Monetary Fund is also called as Bretton Woods institutions. The basic objective behind the creation of IMF was to support the economic and financial system of the world economy. After the Great Depression of 1930s, various economies of the world increased trade barriers, thereby a huge fall in the world trade was seen. Various economies resorted to devaluation of their currency also to sustain, to boost and support the economies to increase their world trade. An agreement which is famously known as Bretton Woods Agreement was entered into with various nations. The IMF was conceived at the United Nations Conference, which was convened in Bretton Woods, New Hampshire, United States, in July 1944. The governments of 44 countries at the Bretton Woods Conference unanimously represented on the fact that a framework should be established at a world level so that the economies do not get trapped in vicious circle of devaluation of their currencies due to depression in the economies. All agreed to support and increase economic cooperations in order to boost world trade, dipping living standard of the people, leading to the dropping of the world trade to a great extent. In 1944, at the Bretton Woods, an agreement was done to establish a new international monetary system. The basic objective to establish IMF was to promote or to foster international financial stability and to extend and encourage the monetary cooperation among the nations. These two objectives were established with a vision to promote, contribute, encourage, and to achieve the increased international trade, high level of employment opportunities in the countries, and achieve sustainable economic growth. It also aimed at reducing the level of poverty worldwide and reduce trade barriers. Finally, IMF was created in 1945. Presently, the IMF is governed by and is accountable to 188 countries that make up its global membership. Therefore, we can say that IMF is an international organization with a membership of 188 countries, which helps in fostering monetary cooperation, achieve financial stability, facilitate international trade to achieve its various objectives. Formally, it started in 1945 with 29 countries. Its headquarters are at Washington, D.C. According to the official website of IMF, the International Monetary Fund, IMF, is an organization of 188 countries working to foster global monetary cooperation, secure financial stability, facilitate international trade, promote high employment and sustainable economic growth, and reduce poverty around the world. Created in 1945, the IMF is governed by and is accountable to 188 countries that make up its near global membership. Governance and organization of International Monetary Fund. The International Monetary Fund is responsible to the governments of its member nations. At the top of its organizational structure is the Board of Governors, which consists of one governor and one alternate governor from each member country. The Board of Governors meets once each year at the IMF World Bank annual meetings. 24 of the governors sit on the International Monetary Fund and Financial Committee, and normally they meet twice each year. The day-to-day work is overseen by its 24-member executive board, which represents the entire membership. This work is guided by IMFC and is supported by the IMF staff. The managing director is the head of the IMF staff and chairman of the executive board, and is assisted by four deputy managing directors. The Board of Governors, the highest decision-making body of the IMF, consists of one governor and one alternate governor for each member country. The governor is appointed by the member country and is usually the Minister of Finance or the governor of a central bank. All powers of the IMF are vested in Board of Governors. The Board of Governors may delegate to the executive board all except certain reserved powers. The Board of Governors normally meet once a year. According to the Charter of IMF, the IMF's primary purpose is to ensure the stability of the international monetary system, the system of exchange rates and international payments that enables countries and their citizens to transact with each other. Working of IMF. All the countries who are the members of International Monetary Fund create a pool of funds by a quota system as a fund of International Monetary Fund. Those countries which have deficit in payments can borrow from that fund. IMF helps to improve the status of the member economies by carrying out several activities pertaining to research and development. So the primary source of the IMF's financial resources is its members' quotas. These quotas are based on the members' relative position in the world economy. In addition, the IMF can borrow temporarily to supplement its quota resources. IMF has also created the new arrangements to borrow, which was expanded in 2011 and can provide supplementary resources. The member countries of IMF have also agreed recently to increase the resources through borrowing agreements. As per the articles of agreement of IMF, its objectives are to promote international economic cooperation, international employment and exchange rate stability, including by making financial resources available to the member countries to meet balance of payment needs. The IMF is the vital organization of the international monetary system. It is not a development agency. It acts as a source of last resort for the member economies in order to gain short-term stability. Let's discuss about the major functions of IMF. The surveillance system of IMF. Any country at any time of the joining of IMF enters into an agreement to go for the scrutiny of all its economic and financial policies at the international level. It also promises and commits to provide all the data to IMF pertaining to its economy. The member nation will have to undertake and pursue all those policies which led to bring price stability, avoid manipulation of exchange rates for unfair competitive advantage. The IMF is also regularly monitoring the economies and it tries to identify the weaknesses that are causing or could lead to financial or economic instability. This process is called as surveillance. So, IMF follows a unique set of system to become proactive in order to avoid any type of crisis in the international monetary system, which is called as surveillance. Under this system, IMF timely and periodically reviews the policies of other member countries. It also keeps a check on various financial developments of the member nations. A proper review is undertaken of various national, regional, as well as global policies. The surveillance is carried at three levels. International Monetary Fund carries surveillance at three levels. First is country surveillance, where regularly, usually, annually comprehensive discussions with the member countries are done as and when needed. This consultation is known as Article 4 consultation. In this, a team of economists visit a member country to assess their economic and financial developments. Then, they carry out discussions with the policymakers and central bank officials. The team brings out a report, which is later presented for the discussions of executive board. The summary of views of executive board is then informed to the government of that very country. The second one is regional surveillance. It involves assessment by the IMF of policies pursued under currency unions, including Euro area, the West African Economic and Monetary Union, the Central African Economic and Monetary Community, and the Eastern Caribbean Currency Union. Timely regional economic outlook reports are also prepared to discuss economic developments and key policy issues in Asia Pacific, Europe, Middle East, and Central Asia, Sub-Saharan Africa, and the Western Hemisphere. The third one is global surveillance. The IMF keeps a regular check on the global trends. As well, it publishes the following reports for analyzing and assessing the various macroeconomics and macroeconomic development throughout the world. The first one is the World Economic Outlook. Second one is the Fiscal Monitor. Third one is the Global Financial Stability Report. It carries out the following functions in order to create a balance in international monetary system. Firstly, it advises member nations so as to how various policies can help to foster economic stability. Secondly, it guides the member nations as to how they can reduce susceptibility to economic and financial crises. Thirdly, through its Global Financial Stability Report, it regularly assesses the global prospects of emerging economies. Fourthly, it regularly publishes a series of regional economic outlooks. And lastly, it helps the low-income economies to develop policies which can help them improve their financial position, fiscal position, standard of living, and reduce level of poverty. The International Monetary Fund usually monitors members' country economies through regular annual consultations. During these consultations, IMF staff carries out serious discussions on various economic and financial factors with policymakers. They help to assess risks and vulnerabilities and consider the impact of fiscal, monetary, financial, and exchange rate policies on the members' domestic and balance of payment stability. Let us discuss about technical assistance by IMF. The IMF grants technical assistance, training, and support to help the member countries so that they can build, improve, and strengthen their capability to design and implement effective policies, keeping in view the global situations. The technical assistance is provided in the key areas of taxation policies of the economies and its administration, expenditure management of the member nations, management and implementation of monetary and exchange rate policies, supervision and regulation of banking and financial systems, legislative frameworks pertaining to the policies, and statistical support. Let us now discuss about lending or financial assistance by IMF. IMF provides financial assistance or funds to member countries if they face balance of payment crisis so as to resolve and eradicate macroeconomic problems, so as to help them in creating stability at the time of crisis. The governments or the national authorities of the member countries design and implement various adjustment programs with the cooperation of IMF, which are supported by IMF financing, which is provided on the condition of effective implementation of the said programs. After global financial crisis, IMF has improved its lending capacity and went into series of reforms in its financial support mechanisms in order to fight back with the global crisis more effectively. IMF is focusing on mitigating and managing the crisis and developing various instruments in order to respond to the situations in an efficient and effective manner. A poverty reduction and growth trust has been specially created to increase the financial support to the world's poorer countries, It is also providing various concessional lendings to low-income economies, the ambit of which has been specially increased after crisis. The access norms and limits were increased by 50% in 2015. Some loans are even provided interest-free through the end 2016. IMF is funding some special lendings in case of emergency at 0% interest rates. Let us discuss about SDRs. The International Monetary Fund created one international reserve in 1969, which is famously called as SDR. This fund supplements the official reserves of member countries. The international reserve asset, known as special drawing rights, can supplement the official reserves of member countries. The value of SDR is based on four key international currencies. SDRs are easily exchangeable for freely usable currencies. SDR was created to support the Bretton Woods fixed exchange rate system. IMF members can voluntarily exchange SDRs for currencies among themselves. Any member country which is participating in this system needed some official reserves. Government or central bank holdings of gold and widely accepted foreign currencies. These currencies could be used to purchase the domestic currency in foreign exchange markets as required to maintain its exchange rate. But gold and US dollar were proved to be inadequate for expanding the world trade. Therefore, the international community resolved to create an international reserve asset under International Monetary Fund. The SDR is neither a currency nor a claim on the IMF. Rather, it is a potential claim on the freely usable currencies of IMF members. Holdings of SDRs can obtain these currencies in exchange of their SDRs in two ways. First is through the arrangement of voluntary exchanges between members. And the second one is by the IMF designating members with strong external positions to purchase SDRs from members with weak external positions. In addition to its role as a supplementary reserve asset, the SDR serves as the unit of account of IMF and some other international organizations. Let us now talk about SDR basket. SDR basket consists of Euro, Japanese Yen, Pound Sterling and US Dollar. The value of the SDR in terms of the US Dollar is determined daily and is posted on International Monetary Fund's website. It is calculated as the sum of specific amounts of the four basket currencies which are valued in US dollars on the basis of exchange rates quoted at noon each day in the London market. The SDR interest rate provides the basis for calculating the interest charged to borrowing members and the interest paid to the members for the use of their resources for regular non-concessional IMF loans. It is also the interest paid to the members on their SDR holdings and charged on to their SDR allocation. The SDR interest rate is determined weekly and is based on a weighted average of representative interest rates on short-term debt instruments in the money markets of the SDR basket currencies. Before I leave, let's summarize the topic. The International Monetary Fund is an international organization created for the purpose of standardizing global financial relations and exchange rates. Thus, the IMF generally monitors the global economy, and its core goal is to economically strengthen its member countries. It provides various kinds of assistance to its member countries in the form of technical and financial assistance. Specifically, the IMF was created with the intention of 1. Promoting global monetary and exchange stability. 2. Facilitating the expansion and the balanced growth of international trade. 3. Assisting in the establishment of a multilateral system of payments for current transactions. Thank you.